tugging back and forth with the Lord on this preaching thing, and just God knows and I don't. But he's had this message ready about 3 months or so, and he just continually asked me, you know, am I ready? I told him Friday night when I took us out to eat for Father's Day, I told him, if he's ready, I am. So we'll make sure God is, and we're going to listen to him try his best tonight. Amen. But you know what? It ain't him. I'm going to listen to him. If he does make half a preacher, it'll be God.
Amen.
It'll be God that does it. Don't depend on the man too much. But depend on the ability of God to take anybody.
Amen.
With a willing heart. And lead them and guide them and bless them and anoint them. So let's just give him all our attention tonight, and we'll trust God to use his mind to come on today.
Amen.
Amen.
How's everybody doing tonight?
Yeah.
Good.
Y'all look about as nervous as I do. So. I don't blame you, though.
We're not nervous.
I know you ain't. You ain't nervous. Let's go to the Lord in prayer before we get started. Dear Lord, I come to you tonight, Lord, just asking you to move me out of the way, Lord. Use me and speak your words through me, Lord. I know this message was for me first, but I know you want it preached. So whoever's in this room that needs it, that they may receive it, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to go to the book of Matthew, chapter 24, starting in verse 4. Y'all will please stand. Bible says, and Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass. But the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places. All these are the beginning of sorrows. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and ye shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. And then shall many be offended, and shall betray one another, and shall hate one another. And many false prophets shall rise and shall deceive many. And because iniquity abound, the love of many shall wax cold. But he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. You can be seated. This is Jesus talking to his disciples about the end of times. As we go through it, I'll put some examples that he showed me throughout this. That this is the end. We're at the end. It's time for him to come back. To start out, there's only one way. That's through the cross and the blood of Jesus. If you haven't asked for forgiveness, you're not saved. You're going to heaven. In verse 5 it says, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. We see this every day with different religions. The new religions popping up every day, such as Scientology and Muslims, the different types of Muslims that keep coming out, Islam, ISIS. Anything, just about anything is coming up there saying that their way is the way. The only way is through this Bible,
right.
Through the words of this Bible. Our Bible does not match up with anybody else's Bible. In verse 6 and 7, it talks about, you shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. We see that every day. There's a new war starting.
Amen.
Somebody's bombing somebody. Somebody's blowing up a concert or anything like that. Nation shall rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom. All religions are fighting against us as Christians. We are delivered up on a daily basis. There's more Christians killed now than any other time in history on a daily basis. And it says, all these are the beginning of sorrow. It says, then they shall deliver you up to be afflicted, which we're already in. You see that every day. They shall kill you, and you shall be hated of nations for my name's sake. Anybody that proclaims Jesus is hated, unless they're talking to another Christian. Sometimes even another Christian is putting you down for proclaiming Jesus' name. Or somebody claiming, I ain't going to say it's another Christian, somebody claiming to be a Christian, let's put it that way. And then shall many be offended, and shall betray one another, and shall hate on one another. Every day you're seeing protests on the news. This offended me. I'm offended because Christians don't like gay rights. Well, it's in the Bible. They're offended because Donald Trump talked to a guy in Russia. They're offended because this person bought Kool-Aid at Walmart. Everybody's offended by something.
Amen.
And many false prophets shall rise and shall deceive many. There's false prophets every day teaching out of a different Bible. They call it the Bible, but it's a different Bible, and they take Jesus out of the picture. They take the blood out of the picture. The resurrection's gone. But they're still telling you they can get you to heaven that way. You can't get to heaven that way. The only way you can get to heaven is through the blood of Christ.
Amen.
And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. There is no love in this nation anymore. In this church, there's a lot of love. We feel it every day. Every time you walk in the door, you can feel the love. But if you go out and you are in a store, you're trying to help somebody or something like that, they don't want your help. They don't. They just want you to give it to them. But he that shall endure until the end, the same shall be saved. This right here means to me, not that if you endure to the end, you shall be saved. But the ones that do endure are saved. And the gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall the end come. This is what we need to be doing at this time. We need to be going out and preaching the word of God. Everybody we come in contact with, we need to be telling them about Jesus. Tell them about the cross, about the resurrection, the only way to heaven through the blood of Christ. Sorry, Doc. For the only way for a Christian to keep going in the right way is to stay on God's path, to stay in the Bible. Read your Bible. Be at church. Fellowship with your Christian brothers, not with the world. If you're fellowshipping with the world, you can't stay on a path to Christ. Exactly. So from this, you can see that we are in the end of times. And that there's no other way to heaven than through Jesus Christ. The only other place you're going is to hell. Nobody wants to burn for for eternity in the devil's hell.
Amen.
I ask for if you are a Christian and you are walking away or you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing, today to come down and get that right with God and start walking the path that you're supposed to walk. We all fail. I fail daily, hourly. If you're not a Christian and you don't know how, there's plenty of men in this room, including myself, women, if you're a woman, that can show you in the Bible how to repent of your sins and what you're supposed to do. I just ask that you let this come to your heart and let Jesus work in your heart, and let's get it done today. Don't walk out of here and not be saved. Not only could he step out on the clouds for the rapture in the next 30 seconds, you couldn't make it. You may not make it to the stop sign without getting hit by a drunk driver. There's no guarantee for tomorrow. So I beg, please, don't walk out of here without being saved today.
Amen.
I would get up here, and it wouldn't take quite as long as I had planned in my head. But that's okay. It's all about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Which I know we have baptism, we have families in here for the baptism, so I was actually kind of glad it didn't take too long. As long as you would like to.